अभी ऑनलाइन नहीं है तन्वी, जस्ट वेट प्लीज, यू जस्ट सेंड मी अ रिक्वेस्ट, आई एक्सेप्टेड, बट या
Hello.
हेलो विनीत सर, हाउ यू?
Very well. How are you?
आई एम गुड, आई एम गुड. अरे आप बाहर से कर रहे हो, पहले बताते तो मैं भी बाहर रहता, इसलिए तो मैंने 5 PM रखा था. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल थैंक यू सो मच फॉर एक्सेप्टिंग दिस माय 5 days 5 inspiration लाइव वीडियोस.
Thank you for
एंड
having me here.
ओके,
Thank you for
लेट मी, सो आई वॉन्ट टू मेक इट सो मच लर्निंग, लाइक आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू आस्क यू द स्टूपिड क्वेश्चंस रिगार्डिंग द सोशल मीडिया एंड इंस्टाग्राम. आई वॉन्ट टू मेक
Sure.
इट मोर नॉलेजेबल.
I mean, it'll be very helpful for anybody who's listening regarding photography. See, social media and Instagram, I'm sure people can learn on themselves. Let's talk about photography so that they can really get a path in photography rather than social media.
ग्रेट ग्रेट सर, ग्रेट. सो लेट मी स्टार्ट विद अ वेरी बेसिक क्वेश्चन. लाइक जब हम लोग फोटोग्राफी सीख रहे होते हैं, सो वी ऑलवेज फॉलो द सम मास्टर फोटोग्राफर्स वर्क. लाइक आई हैव सीन योर वर्क, आई हैव सीन सी मैकर्स वर्क, आई हैव सीन रघुराय सर का काम. बट जब आप फोटोग्राफी जब आपने स्टार्ट करी थी, तो हु आर द मास्टर फोटोग्राफर्स जिनका काम आपने स्टडी किया है? आई एम श्योर के मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल डोंट नो देम, बिकॉज आपने बहुत ज्यादा स्टडी किया है फोटोग्राफर्स को, तो हु आर
मतलब यू आर
दे?
ट्राइंग टू से कि मैं इतना बुजुर्ग हो गया हूँ, मैं इतना बूढ़ा हो गया
नो,
हूँ
आई एम नॉट सेइंग वी आर ऑलमोस्ट द सेम एज, आई डोंट लुक लाइक दिस.
नो, यू आर वे यंगर टू मी. सो कमिंग बैक टू वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग क्वेश्चन एंड वेरी आई वुड लाइक टू टेल ऑल द व्यूअर्स दैट आई फॉलो पेंटर्स, आई डोंट फॉलो फोटोग्राफर्स. There is, and if you will ask me to pinpoint one photographer, I can't really pinpoint, but I really follow painters, and I
Oh,
feel that
you have done a fine arts,
yes,
graduation
I've
fine arts.
done, yes, I've done fine arts, but also, as we all know, photography came into existence because of paintings, and so I felt that let me just get back to where it started from. So I follow painters. I like Renoir's work a lot. I like Edgar Degas' work a lot. And then talking about masters, I think I've learned everything from everybody and I'm still learning. People like you, people like anybody around me who are even younger or even who are just my peer, I'm learning from them every day because I feel like doctors keep practicing. If photographers don't, don't keep practicing, they will cease to exist. So that's what I'm doing. I'm learning every day.
But if you want to take any one or three names जिनका आप चाहते हो कि the people who are listening you, they go through their work and they study their work, that how they shoot or how they when they go to the street, so how they see the street, so आप ऐसे तीन कौन से photographers का नाम आप बोलना चाहोगे for the beginners, जिनका काम वो देख के स्टडी कर सकते हैं? लाइक वी ऑल नो यू, वी ऑल नो यू, हम आपका काम इतना ज्यादा देखते आ रहे हैं, तो वी वॉन्ट टू हेयर फ्रॉम योर मे फ्रॉम यू कि आप किन लोगों का काम आपको लगता है कि यार उनका काम बहुत अच्छा है, एंड पीपल कैन सी देयर वर्क एंड दे कैन लर्न.
See, I feel social media has become so good today that you can look at, you think of a photographer and you can learn from their work. That is one thing. But if you really want to look at master's work, then I would suggest a book called Magnum Contact Sheets.
Oh
They're very, very good.
I'm
You
looking for that
must.
book as well. I'm planning to
So,
buy that book from Amazon.
yeah, it's very good. You should look at that work, that body of work. There are a lot of Indian photographers people must look into. I really like Dinesh Khanna's work, but he's not putting the real work on Instagram. He's enjoying himself, but do look at his books. They are very good.
Yeah,
They're
Bazaar and
very,
all, yeah.
yes, they're very good work. I think if you want to see how India looked like about 20, 30 years back, it is a good documentation of our times. So, and
Okay.
Raghuraj sir, Raghuveer
Yeah.
Singh.
Yeah,
They're
Raghuveer Singh, yeah.
very good. They're very good photographers, and we can. There's also a Pablo Bartholomew. I don't know if
Pablo
you've heard
Garga.
about.
I know,
He's
I know.
very good. So these
Yes.
are the guys which we. I'm talking about Indian guys. We must look into, because end of the day, I feel photography is also about the place we are staying in. So if you really want to look at Indian work, then these are the names you must look into. And then if you want to look at, I also like Aman Chhotani's work a lot. He's doing that last Avatar book. I really like his
book. Yeah. He also put very less work on the social media.
Yeah, I'm fond of Rohit's work also. Rohit and you know, there's so many photographers. I'm talking about my age bracket, right?
Mm-hmm.
Then you are doing a fantastic work, but you are not categorizing yourself into one particular genre.
Yeah, I know.
So I think when it comes to learning, it is also what we want to learn. And if we are good learners, we'll pick up from anything.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So that is, let me come to your main thing. Like whenever I go to the photo walk, people ask me that aapko bahut zyada chance milta hai Vineet sir ke saath walk karne ka. How he framed those photographs? Maybe some photographs look totally unbelievable. They are so good in frame. Like aap pe dog wali series agar main baat karun, to wo dog ki jo peeche poonch ja rahi hai wo ekdam wo hai, like it is connected with the bus and all. So they don't believe that you actually created that photograph without, you know, without you're shooting candid. They don't believe you're shooting candid.
Are they trying to say that I understand dogs really well and I can tell them how to stand in a certain posture? So, I understand dog language and they understand my language.
So I just want to know that how much hard work you have done and how much time you have spent on the field to understand the environment. I remember you always say, Nimit, don't go out and start shooting. Just start observing the environment. So how much that thing is important for the young photographers? Because I have seen they go out and they start shooting. They don't observe the thing. So how much that observing the environment help the young photographers?
See, Nimit, I totally, with me and you, we've shot extensively together. You know, there was time when we were shooting every Sunday together. And also, we've done some professional work also together. What I suggest to people is that any work, be it cooking also, you need to put in hard work and you need to put in your soul. And when you put in your soul into something, something good is going to turn up. But you have to understand yourself first.
Yep.
It is about what you want to show. You know, a lot of us, what we do is when we step out, we keep seeing. We don't look. That is the difference. I want them to look. I want all of us to look and see what connects with us and try to show what we want to show, rather than, imitating somebody is not going to take you anywhere. If I also want to tell them that be yourself, believe in yourself, everybody else is taken. If you, if you like to create a work and somebody looks at it and says that, oh, this is XYZ's work, then the whole process is lost. It should be, we all photographers, we try to find our own signatures in pictures. Yeah. If somebody looks at somebody's work and says, oh, this is, XYZ's picture, then that is what we are looking at. And photography is all about a dialogue. Yeah. It is like a pitch of voice. Photography for me is a voice. And if anybody looks at my picture and says, oh, this is Vineet Vora's voice, then it solves the purpose for me. So everybody should look for their own voice in photography.
I'm sure that you have achieved that level. Whenever we see a photograph of yours anywhere without your name, we can tell that it is a Vineet Vora's work.
Because I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing.
No, you have created that style. You have created that style that we know that it's your work. So, which is even I was discussing with Tanvi about you that I'm going to live with him. So, she even said ke what she like about you before 3 or 4 years when we go to the photo walks. Now, people think in Delhi street photography means Chandni Chowk. But aapne wo cheez todi hai. You started telling people that street photography can come from anywhere. It's not just Chandni Chowk ke aap wahin pe jaake shoot kar rahe hain. So you have done a series on buses as well. Aapke bahut sare pushkar wale shot hain. Delhi mein normally jab aap shoot karte hain, wo mera ball wala shot jo bahut famous hai, that is your composition. Aapne mujhe bataya tha ki
kaise. No, it is. You shot it.
So How you come up those ideas? Like if any beginner, like they are going, usually still I have seen people are going to the Chandni Chowk. So what is that one suggestion you would like to give them as a street photographers, what they can do to make them better?
So street photography firstly is not about location. It is about approach. it can start the minute you step out of home. In fact, you know, in your backyard, it can start from there. So don't make it a point that you have to go somewhere to shoot street. The minute you step out, start looking. I would also suggest that, you know, for some time, start shooting without the camera. You know, there are a lot of times when we step out and we don't have a camera, we are finding shots everywhere. But the minute we have camera, we can't find a shot. Now, the whole thing happens is when we have a camera, we feel that we have a job to make a picture. So don't think you are on a job to make a picture. It should be like, you know, it is lying. The camera is with you. You find something, take a picture. In the end of maybe one shot in a month, if it makes you happy, then it's good. Don't try become a fact. Go ahead.
Okay, that's what I want to hear. That usually people when they go out from their houses, they want 10 photographs leke hi aani hai, and then they get disappointed. But I have seen ke jab main aapke saath bhi walk karta hun, you don't go with that attitude ki aaj mujhe click karna hi hai. You go very with a flow. So that is more important. Or sometimes planning can help the photographers to get a shot.
See, the joy of street photography is that you can never plan it. That is the fun. So how can you step out that, okay, I have a certain plan today and I will follow that plan. The whole joy of street photography is that it is temporary. You can never go with a plan. At times you can just walk the street and you can find interesting backgrounds. You can spend some time there and try to connect something. Or at times you find good subjects and then you wait for them to appear in front of good backgrounds. So hunting and fishing, I would say they are two techniques which are very, very good in street photography. But don't go fishing for ducks where there are no ducks. So try to find the right place. Chandni Chowk or the Old Delhi, I think a lot of us, we like that place because, you know, it is free for all and nobody objects taking pictures. That is easy. But I would say try shooting in your own background and then you'll know what street photography is and what are the challenges. Street photography is not about, I would repeat, not about location. So you can start it anywhere.
So let me continue with the fishing part. Jo aapne fishing ka bola. So sometimes it is important if you find a good location. So you can stay there for 10 minutes, 15 minutes. You can wait for the perfect subject. Uske saamne se jaye, then you can grab. I have seen when I was shooting with you in West Bengal, I think. So you were waiting there for 10, 15 minutes when we were shooting that kids wala shot. So how, maybe it is उस चीज को हम कैसे पहचाने? Like I was also shooting with you, but मेरे को वो फ्रेम नहीं दिख पा रहा था जो आपको दिख रहा था. तो वो कैसे एक बंदा डेवलप, एक amateur, एक beginner photographer कैसे डेवलप करे हुआ है? We can't see the layers. We just see the 2D photographs, but you create those 2D photographs into a 3D, which is a main powerful thing.
All right. So let's understand this. Very simple. I would suggest A, B, C to all my listeners. A is aesthetics, B is background, and C is content. And C can also be composition. So these three things keep in mind. And for layers, if you'll ask about layers, layers is, you know, it's why do we feel that an image is three-dimensional? Because it has three platforms, which is, you know, background, midground, and foreground. Sure. So at times you can start with the background and keep stepping back. Or you can move forward where you can create a good foreground and work the scene accordingly. Don't overlap. Try very simple, you know. You don't really have to get 10 people in the frame to make the layers work. I would say try with 3 people and then keep moving back and add more people in your frame. Avoid overlap, but to have the right content, it is your voice. What you want to show in the frame is very, very important. Just by having 5 people with separation doesn't really guarantee that it will be a good frame. But if there is certain temporariness in the frame and you feel that this moment is not going to repeat, then it works.
Okay.
So try it.
So Dimpy sent me a question that what is your viewpoint on using flash in street photography? Like, I'm not understand her question, but I'm sure she's so good in street.
Okay, it's a very valid question. What I, you know, I understand Dimpy because she's worked with me. And the whole point could be whether it's ethical to use flash or is it okay to use flash in street photography. Now, a lot of people have different school of thoughts. I personally don't use flash because I feel it is artificial light and it is adding on or lighting up the scene. But I have nothing against people who are using it because street photography is nothing. There are no particular rules, only the photographer. If his ethics are right, he decides the rules. And street photography is, when I keep on saying that it is about voice, your voice, your voice, I also feel that street photography is all about you. You decide what is street photography. So keep certain things in mind that it has to be candid. That is very important. And secondly, it has to be temporary. The minute the viewer feels. Now, simple example. If you're watching a movie, street is like watching a movie. The minute we can put a finger and put a pause, that is the time the photographer has taken a picture. Now, when the viewer looks it, he should have that movie and he should able to press that play button on that picture. And when he presses play, everything should come back into action. Yep. So that is what street photography is to me.
Okay, that's a very great explanation. I'm sure ke aisa explanation ab tak to maine nahi suna tha. This is first time when I'm
coming back to Dimpy's question about flash. I think it is to each his own. I'm not really against using it, but I don't use it.
Okay,
it is
okay.
But for me, it is, you know, when we say that, you know, some people say it's not ethical to use flash or it is not. But then I can also say that why are we converting into black and white? You know, we're seeing the things in color, then we are converting into black and white. So yeah. It is manipulation. So it is to each his own. If you actually feel that this is about manipulation, then flash is not manipulating.
Okay. Manipulation means the flash manipulation. I just want to tell the viewer, it's not about the Photoshop manipulation. Street photography means pure candid and pure without any unedited photographs. Yeah. You have judged so many photography contests, bade-bade contests aapne judge kiye hain. So, ye ek bahut hi logon ka mere paas question aaya tha ki when we are submitting our photograph, hum bahut baar reject ho jate hain. They think ki unki photograph kafi achhi hai, but tab bhi wo reject ho jate hain. So, as a judge, aap kya un photographs mein dekhte ho ke aapko wo achhi lage? Like, I know that every judge has their own perspective or taste, but as a street photographer, आप क्या एक photograph में ढूंढते हो? आपको क्या चीज़ है जो appeal सबसे पहले करती है कोई भी photograph देख के?
So there are three things which I look into a picture. Firstly, I want to know or see a fresh voice or the individual voice, something which I haven't heard. I keep on saying voice because when I look at picture, they talk to me. The image should talk to you as a photographer. I look for voice in the picture. Then I also look at a fresh perspective. Then I want to see, the whole purpose of a picture is to create a dialogue. And if that image is creating a dialogue, then I will look into it. Judging is very, very difficult job. You can never please people.
I know.
And it is also very subjective. It is, sadly, it is also, you know, a lot depends on the mood of the photographer. I'm very honest saying that. If in a happy mood, I look for pictures which are spreading happiness. And when I'm in a sad mood, then I'll probably invariably look for pictures which are conveying a mood or a scene which are on a sad part. So it is a very thankless job. But that should not be any photographer's aim, to be in a competition. The only competition a photographer has is himself. His picture should be better than his last picture. That is it. So don't fall into this really big fiasco of competition. Competition really gives you adulation. It gives you instant recognition, which is very good. Keep trying it. But don't let it disappoint you. Learn from your mistakes. Learn from the pictures which are winning. But don't think that I'm better and they are not better.
Never compare with anyone.
So never compare apples.
We can't compare Leonardo and Michelangelo. Like, they both are the great artists.
They have their own identity. They're different styles and it is different. So don't ever compare yourself.
So one more question came to me, like how how much important to read a book, photography books, to understand photography. And if you want to tell three books which they can, the beginners can read and learn, to unko help kare. Ek to aapne Magnum batai diya, because Magnum ka maine bhi dekha tha, so it is a very good book. Uske alawa, what are the two other books which you can suggest?
I like Kudelka's work, Joseph Kudelka's. I also would encourage all of you to probably read about painters. Understanding light will come from there. Photography, we all know, there's a big saying, it is nothing but a painting of light. So when we know it's a painting of light, then please read painters, their autobiographies about their lives and why they painted in a certain fashion. It will help you improve your work. So I would suggest them to read Van Gogh's work. It is very, very good.
So because I know, okay, I think I just read somewhere that Henri Cartier-Bresson and even Ansel Adams, they used to paint their frames before, sometimes before shooting. So that's how they can, you know, imagine what they are going to shoot. And that's how they learn.
So, yeah, so we everything, we learn something from everything. So that is because even in the current bandwagon of photographers, there is something to learn from everyone. Everyone, you know, some people are good at composition. Some people, you know, are also good at selling themselves. I have no problem in that. So try and understand what you want out of your own pictures. That is very important.
Mohit Khetrapal ne ye question pucha hai ki how to build a great vision towards surroundings. Aas paas ki duniya ko kaise dekhte hain sir? Like, we all want to know ke how you see the world, because aapki photograph se the world look totally different. So how you see the world?
Okay, so vision is something you know, we prepare ourselves over a period of time. If all of us go for a photo walk today, and let's take a kid who's 6-year-old and give him a camera, he will see the world differently. He will, because we all of us have so much of baggage of images which we see every day. We try to somehow are not able to get rid of those images. So let's get rid of the images which we've seen and have fresh pair of eyes every day. If you find, what I feel is that if there's a stretch of 100 meters and I want to make a picture from that place, and you know, there is something like a job, if I must say that in this 100 meters I have to create a picture, then I will walk that stretch, look for 5 elements which appeal to me, and I will walk that stretch again and try to look for 5 elements which I never saw it in the first place. And I will repeat it 4-5 times till the time there's the minutest of elements which I missed in the first 3 walks, and try to create a frame around it. So whenever we walking in a surrounding, try to look for things which otherwise you will miss. It could be a label on the bottle. It could be, you know, color red, which you fancy, or it's just the composition, how you feel about the place. Try to talk to yourself as a photographer a lot. So that will help.
Okay. So that means ke if I want to say it in a simple language, ke agar aap apni photographs ko bhi kai baar dekh ke you understand, you learn so many things. Jab aap ghar pe aake apni photographs dekhte hain, so you understand ke arre ye aisa nahi, aisa karta, so maybe better hota. So next time you have an idea ke okay kaise, like you also keep looking your old work and maybe read your old photographs ke aapne kya kiya tha.
I very often learn from my mistakes. I think pictures which don't work, they teach you much more than images which work. Because just to understand where you faltered or why you failed will give you a much better platform to understand something, how you can take the next step. I'll tell you an example. There was this street, or there was this wall, in fact, where I went for 12 days to get a shot. Every day for 10-15 minutes. And I could not manage a shot. But I used to read my shots every day, that where am I going wrong? Why is the timing so wrong? So I understood that on the 12th day, that when I'll start moving with my subject at his pace, that is the time I can manage that shot. So understand those nuances. Where are you going wrong? Why or what is that reason that your timing is not getting okay with that particular shot? I think everybody's seen that shot, that cow shot with a tree at the back in Pushkar. It is not that I saw it. It is just there and I take that shot. I was really amazed by that tree. You know, if we all go there about 4 years back, that was the first thing which all of us was seeing, that this tree is so big and it is so beautiful. And I always kept thinking that how can I create a picture around it, or how can I use it in my landscape? So one day when I saw this bull passing by, I thought that, and it had big horns, and I thought that maybe there's a picture. It went by too quickly. The third day when I came, there were cows around it. So I had to wait for 20 minutes to make a shot from there. It is not that I instantly saw it and made a picture. So now you feel that it is so easy and you can just juxtapose. But it is also practice which understands that, okay, there is a certain level where you can place yourself or stand and make a much better shot.
Okay. Mohit asked the importance of knowing the difference between editing and post-processing. Like, I think editing and post-processing, I don't know. Like,
yes, it is a very valid question again.
Like, he's asking, you understand well.
Yes. So editing in street photography is selecting the right shot. When you come back with 20 shots and you want to show, or maybe show the moment which works the best out of those 20 shots, that is called the edit. You know, that is the editing. Processing is the Photoshop or Lightroom. That is the processing part of it. Editing is always selection of the right picture. Similarly, when we are seeing a movie, we always say that, okay, the movie had a good edit. It doesn't mean that the processing was really good. It means that it was cut at the right time. So when there are 5 or 6 shots from the same place and you pick up the shot which works, that is the edit.
Okay. And how much post-processing is, acceptable in street photography? Like, we know that a landscape mein toh, there are no rules and regulations. People do like so many blending and everything. But when I'm doing Astro, toh, there are so many editing is, happened in the take out that one photograph. But how much editing is applicable in acceptable in street photography?
Next to none. You know, I would say that if you can't get it right in the first place, you will never get it right. And be it any genre of photography, be it landscape, be it product, if you do too much of processing, the whole idea gets lost. The viewer has a right to know whether he's looking, or maybe, let's make a photograph as a book. Okay, let's keep it like it's a novel. So the viewer has a right to know whether this is a fact or fiction. Now, if it is over processed, it becomes very fictitious. If the sky isn't blue and you're forcing it to look red, then obviously it is not going to look nice. So keep it very, very low. For social media, yes, you have to add a little bit of saturation, a little bit. And you have to add a little bit of blacks to make it more contrasty, and a little bit of sharpening. That is it. Don't touch your pictures. I would say shoot manual, learn to get it right in the first place.
Okay, and shoot manual ki baat hai, so I want to, like, so many people are confused between zone system. They don't understand a zone focusing system. So can you explain a little bit about it?
Okay, zone is an entire class. I mean, it might take half an hour to just make you understand zone. Okay, so let's make it simple. Zone is how far you are from your subject and how much distance. Like, if you want from 3 feet to 10 feet in focus, then that's how you measure. So from your eye to that 1/3 of 10 feet, it should be your focal point. I only shoot with manual lenses and manual camera. So I only shoot, on zone focus. And so zone is something else, and hyperfocal distance is something else. A lot of people also confuse between hyperfocal distance and zone focusing. Zone focusing is used normally in street photography because, you have to be quick, and certain places you can't make your camera hunt for focus. So you know that my subject is about 6 feet and I want from 3 feet to 10 feet, everything in focus. So I would say that keep your focus at 4 feet and use an F3 F13 or F16, everything will be intact focus. So experiment. Okay.
Experiment.
Yeah. A lot of autofocus lenses are not great with that. So you will have to find really old lenses, which are very good manual lenses, which work much better with zone focusing.
Okay. So Dimpy also sent me a question like, what is the future of street photography?
Future. Today, we don't even know what our future holds in next 2 weeks. How can we tell about street photography? I just hope that social distancing doesn't mean or make it like mandatory and we street photographers just sit at home and we are not making enough shots. Future is something, you know, a lot of street photographers are actually doing campaigns for ads and they're shooting campaigns in a street style. So a lot of us don't really have to feel that there is a future for something. That is why you're doing something. Today, we don't know what is the future of, you know, Instagram. About 5 years back, all of us felt that Facebook was the thing and everybody was on Facebook. Today, I personally feel that a lot of people, everybody wants to be on Instagram. Maybe day after tomorrow, there is some other platform.
Which is even
good. Flickr was there and which is still there, but you know, we can't really predict what is the future. Future of photography is, I personally feel, if you understand that street photography is like writing notes to yourself, then you won't worry about the future. It is not going to pay us. So let's make it a point that we are doing it for ourselves. If something makes money out of it, good. If it doesn't, you never intended to make money. So don't worry about the future. Work in the
future. And most of the people don't know that you also working on a documentary, like you're documenting your Buswali series. And there are so many other series also you're working. So aajkal ke street photographers, they are not working on documentary, like they are not working on documenting any one subject or particular place, or, you know, they are going out, they are shooting without any theme or something like that. So how kitna important hai document kisi cheez ko karna in street photography?
Okay.
It can help them in future as well, or become a better photographer, or, you know, better learner. Yeah.
Okay. Street photography is an actual document. I would say anything which we take is a document. And street photography is a subjective documentation of any aspect or anything which is unfolding in front of us. Coming to how important documentary is, or documenting the place around us is, anything, the pictures which we are viewing today, after 30 years, they're going to be something else. Because if you look at some images from Delhi about 30 years back, they appear totally different today.
Yeah.
So even if we don't put an effort on documenting a place, it is still happening. If you see Jama Masjid shots about 30 years back, or even 5 years back, you know, there was no grill inside Jama Masjid. You remember, we've done that. And now there's a strong grill. You can't even stand there and make pictures. So it is changing. Who knows, maybe after 10 years, they put something else. So things are changing. So after my suggestion to all the photographers, street photographers especially, after you feel that you've started getting one winners or two winners everywhere, now work on series. Series is very important. It'll give you a rhythm. It'll give you a voice. It'll make you work or understand your own work in a much better way. So start working on series. It is very important.
Okay. Gaurav Chhabra asks, challenges in street photography and how to tackle the same. Like if someone also asks me, ke, you know, when they go out to the shoot a street, तो लोगों को पसंद नहीं आता है, दे हैव अ फेयर कि ना लोग डांटेंगे, ये करेंगे. तो आप जब शूट करते हैं, आप इतने पास से शूट करते हैं, आई हैव सीन यू कि आप बहुत ही पास से, बनारस में जब व्हेन यू आर शूटिंग, तो आप बहुत ही पास जाके शूट करते हैं, तो आपने वो मेरी वैसे डर से लोग कैसे वापस बाहर आए, लाइक हाउ कैन दे लर्न दैट?
ओके, ट्राई एंड अंडरस्टैंड ऑन द स्ट्रीट एवरीबॉडी यू सी, ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड, दे आर लाइक स्ट्रीट डॉग्स. व्हेन वी वॉकिंग ऑन द स्ट्रीट, there are certain dogs we know that they're going to bark, and certain dogs we know if we go close, we can easily pet them.
Yeah.
And you, nobody else can know better, because you are very fond of street dogs. I've seen you playing with dogs like that. But also at the same time, you know there are certain dogs which will bite and you never
bite. Yeah, I know. Yeah.
So, take people like that. Smile a lot. Go closer and make. Firstly, you know, a lot of us, what we do is we just pick up the camera straight and walk to them. No. Go close. Make your presence felt to them. It is like they should know that you're not harming them. Don't look into their eyes. Don't have eye contact. When you feel the moment is ready, then pick up the camera and take a shot. Don't think that you're carrying a gun and get inside that and start shooting people. It should not be shooting. Doesn't literally mean that you start shooting. Please understand there are certain ethics as photographers. You have to respect the space they're walking, the space they are in, and also understand this is the same space where our parents walk, our families walk. So we should give them equal respect.
Yep. Okay. Well said. Because I have seen that when rehearsal, usually people go to the camera and they go inside and they are practicing. Mm. So even we said sometimes ke give them some respect. They are doing their you know job. So I have seen you that you never disturb anyone when you are shooting. Yeah. So giving the respect is very important. That wise, I'll ask ke how much black and white photography is important as far as street shots are concerned.
Okay, I don't do black and white photography. I had a talk yesterday also, and same question cropped up. There was a time when I did black and white photography, but I shot on Leica monochrome, which just shoots black and white. So I never had the option of converting into color of that camera. It only shoots black and white. So I shot it for a year, but I understood that my strength or the way I look at the world is in color. But how I would say that it is also your own personal preference. Now, there are people who understand or who like Sufi music. There are people who like disco music. So you have to, and I'm not comparing that, you know, black and white is Sufi and color is disco. It is your own preference. Look at the picture. Look at the form. If it demands to be black and white, or if you understand the image or the underlying emotion of the frame in black and white, please shoot black and white. It is also what the moment demands. So take it as it is. Don't have prefixes that I'm only going to shoot color or I'm only going to shoot black and white. Don't be rigid. Understand the situation and then decide accordingly.
Okay. So let me end this live because I don't want to take you more time because I know you are so busy. So just last one question.
Yeah.
If you want to give a one suggestion to the photographers who are today, so what is going to be that? One or two or three, any suggestions you want to give?
Okay.
Regarding street photography.
Firstly, don't process your images too much. At least once in a month, make or maybe give yourself a discipline that you will only shoot 36 pictures in the entire week. Try to take it as a film roll. And when you know the value of the shot, you will shoot less. See more, shoot less is very important. Thirdly, always question yourself, why should you press the shutter instead of how you should press the shutter? It is always why. The question, when you'll question yourself that what is there in that picture, which is, or maybe forcing you to press the shutter.
That's what you taught me, that why and when you have to press the shutter, you should know.
Yeah. And whenever, you know, it is, when you look at the picture, it should be always that, it should be what the hell, why the hell, and who the hell in the picture. And that will make you much more interesting. And also, please understand anybody who wants to get into street photography, that it is simply, it's about a lie. Street photography is a lie that lies behind the truth. Whatever we are witnessing is a truth. But we have to pick up a shot or a moment, which is entirely a lie and which is able to show subjective interpretation. And if you want to show truth, then you document. Then it becomes more of documentary. And also, you know, it is more of journalism. So that is the basic difference. Subjective versus objective.
Okay, that's great. A question that you're honest is asking, how to overcome from the creative block?
overcome from creative block, leave photography for a while. I've, you know, all of us, we face, it's like a creative writer's block also. Whenever one feels it, that there is a block, start looking or maybe watching movies, listening to song, whatever you like. Maybe pick up an instrument to learn. And when you, if you feel that you need to learn something or create something very, with a lot of heart, then you will come back to photography. It is, just don't worry about. So don't look for inspirations. Inspiration will find you. Just enjoy yourself. That is the key thing. In any any process or any work, if you don't enjoy it, then don't leave it right then and there. But believe in yourself. If anybody can do it, you can do it better.
Okay. That's a great thing. That's a great suggestion, sir. Thank you so much, sir, for joining me.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
I will see you soon because I know I'm ditching you from away so many months. But I'll see you after Corona. Now we understand the importance of freedom. So I will definitely meet you after the Corona. Sure. Thank you so much, sir. I'll see you soon. Thank you so much.
And everybody, please follow social distancing and please stay at home. Please. All right. We'll step out very soon. Take care.
Especially bye-bye. Especially for the influencers who are going out and shooting on this situation. So don't go out. Like Instagram ke liye sab kuch mat karo. Just stay at your houses.
Okay. So, somebody is, says, are the influencers going out? I don't
know. We have seen 3-4 photographers. They are going out and they are shooting. They are showing ke mask pehen ke Corona enough. Like, that is very idiotic things they are doing. So that is not a right thing. That is not a right thing.
Take care, guys. Take care.
Yeah. Thank you so much, sir. We'll bye-bye, sir.
Thank you, Nimit. Bye-bye.
Thank you so much, sir.